Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my March empties. I know I'm a little bit late. I just haven't been filming recently, so I'm trying to catch up with all the videos I didn't get to post last week. I was not feeling my best, so I took a few days off. No big deal. I'm just going to have to play catch up now. My goal for this year is to use up $1,000 worth of empties, just like I did last year. And although I'm not anywhere close to my goal right now, I am very excited that I'm moving stuff out every month. So not a lot of empties this month either. I will put my total right here on the screen of my totals for the month of March. I still don't know my total right now. I just wanted to sit and film and then do all the math afterwards. So I will add it to my yearly total and hopefully I'm at least close to $100. I don't think I'm even close to $100 as of now. So we'll see how that adds up. Very few empties, but of course every little bit counts. And the good news is that I am moving stuff out and decreasing my inventory. So let's go ahead and get started. I want to point out that I feel that the reason why my empties haven't been so good recently is because I've been working on a lot of sample size products. And I do not calculate the sample size value to my yearly totals. I only calculate full size, so that might be working against me, but at the same time, I am currently working on a lot of full size products. I decided to change that around, so it's still gonna take me a while before I can use up a full size product. But here's a sample. I believe this is a sample size, and if it's not, if it's a travel size, I will put the total in the description box. As always, I do list every item in the description box along with their totals. So for now, I think this is a sample, but I'm not sure. This is from Nuxe or Nux Paris, and it is a detox anti-aging moisturizer. That's what it is. Sorry, everything is in French here. And this was very scented, like super scented, but it was really nice moisturizer. I used it at nighttime, and although I really enjoyed it, I just think that the fragrance was a little too much for my skin, and I did find that when I was using it frequently, it would kind of break me out. I believe this is a high-end brand, and although I'm very interested in investing on skincare, I'm not really sure how I feel about the fragrance, but it did make my skin feel soft. I think it's a good moisturizer if you have the money and if you don't mind the fragrance. I got this on a Nipsey bag. I personally will not be repurchasing it though. The next skincare item is actually a full-size product that I've been working on for the longest time because I need to use it sparingly because it breaks me out. This is from Avon and it is the Anew Ultimate Night Multi-Performance Cream. It is a heavy nighttime moisturizer. Now, this I've purchased a few times already because this is the nighttime cream that my grandma uses. And she is aging so gracefully that, of course, I want to try her skincare routine, right? So that's why I've been repurchasing it multiple times. But I need to stop because this is too heavy for my skin. It breaks me out. And no matter how much I want to age like my grandma, I don't want to be breaking out either. I gotta accept the fact that all skincare works differently for everybody. This is a pretty big jar and I used every last bit of it, as you can see. I'm glad I tried it. I'm glad that I now know this is not gonna work for me. I've noticed that anything heavily fragranced or like heavy on the skin breaks me out. I need moisture, but not this heavy. I need something more lightweight. So I will not be repurchasing, but I think it's a good one. I mean, I see my grandma's results and they're great. I only have one hair care product and that is this sample. Again, I think it's a sample. It might be a travel size, I don't know. But this is from Living Proof and it is the Blowout Styling and Finishing Spray. This is like a, it kind of works the way a hairspray does, but without leaving your hair feeling crispy. It took me forever to use it up. I said it before, I always have bad hair day. I mean, just right now, this is just air dried hair with nothing but a little oil to help my really dry ends. That's all. And this is what I do almost every day. I don't wash my hair every day, but when I do, this is what I do. I let it dry and leave it alone. So I'm glad I'm trying all these hair care products, but honestly, I cannot give you proper reviews because I am not a hair girl. I don't know how to do my hair. So I'm glad it's out of my stash. And that's what matters to me right now, that it's one less product in my hoard. I'm not sure I will repurchase. I don't think it's something I need for my current hair care routine, which is practically non-existent. I have three makeup related items. The first one is the one you see every month. These are the e.l.f. cleansing cloths. And I mean, should I keep saying this, you guys? I'm always gonna repurchase this product. Always. That's definitely a staple in my routine. And so is the Too Faced Mascara Melt Off. This is a sample that I received as a gift with purchase sometime last year. And I pulled it out after finishing my full size. So I am planning on picking up the full size again because I feel that this makes all the difference when it comes to removing mascara. It's effective. And I love what it does for my lashes. I also went through a mascara. This is a sample size of the Bobbi Brown Smokey Eye Mascara. This mascara was good. I felt like it did a great job on holding up the curl and providing some length, but it didn't provide any volume for me. I feel like I need a lot more than what this mascara does. And being Bobbi Brown, I am predicting that it's gonna be a high-end product. Currently, my favorite mascara ever is the IT Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. And this one doesn't even come close to that one. So I'm glad I tried it, but I will not be repurchasing. And my last category of empties are my nail products. As always, we have a nail polish remover because, you know, me and my nails. I have a regular nail polish remover, which is from Ulta. And I also tried the equate beauty which is available at Walmart, and this is the 100% acetone nail polish remover. I use the acetone to clean up around my cuticles after I'm done with my nails, so I finally finished it. It will hang around for quite a while. I like both items. I do prefer buying all my nail care stuff from Ulta just because of their reward system. So even though this acetone, I mean, it's acetone, it works, it's effective. Even though this one was good and very affordable, I'm definitely gonna try to find acetone from Ulta because, again, rewards. And last but definitely not least, I have my favorite, my most exciting empty of this month. It is the nail polish, and this is a full-size Covergirl Outlast Stay Brilliant nail polish in the color Black Diamond. It is a very basic black cream polish, but it was part of my project polish, so I'm very excited that it's finally empty. I know that, you know, being a black polish, it's hard for you to see that it's actually empty, but I mean, I'm clearly seen straight through the bottle right now. I'm so happy to get a polish out of my collection, especially when they're as old as this one. If you want more information on my project polish, make sure to check out my most recent update, which will be linked up in the cards as well as down in the description box for you. All right, guys, so that's it. Short and sweet once again. I was planning on maybe putting together my empties for March and April and just make a longer video, but I cannot hang on to all this trash for another month. Even though it's not a lot, I don't like hanging on to trash. So I'm gonna go ahead and dispose of this trash properly, and we'll see meet you here again towards the end of April with my April empties, and hopefully April brings more empties. We'll see, we'll strive for that. But if I don't, it's fine as long as I'm making progress and using up what I'm hoarding. As always, you guys, thank you so much for spending some of your time with me today. I really appreciate it. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next one.